glazed donut. This is glazed donut.
I need that.
What are these things?
Charcoal on top of it. Where are they?
Two in hands.
What
are these? Apple.
That's it. Your buddy up at Sandy's. Yeah.
Hello there.
Well, I think it's a damn shame. It's good food. Here, you can have a bite if you like, but it's his trip, and I guess he's probably burned out on working day in and day out. And I don't blame him if he can afford to retire. Good for him.
I just wanted to always come here and see what it's really like, and it's really good. Really enjoying and gonna miss him. I had a chance to meet Joe, and he's a really nice guy. Well, he's a jolly feller, kind of like Santa Claus, I guess you'd say. I guess that's about the best way to describe it, since he's brought so much happiness to Lawrence for so long. And it's good that people are remembering him the way they are.
I'm sad. I'm real sad. Where are we going to go now?
Really, when you work till 6 o'clock in the morning, there aren't many places you can go to. Not and get good food.
True. Yeah, very true.
I know it's been said before, and it'll be said again, he's an institution in Lawrence, and somebody may buy this place out and open up another donut shop, but it's not going to be Joe's. You know, and I'll tell you, I'm going to miss, I think back 30 years from now, I know I'm going to think back on this. I'm going to think back on KU and my education. Joe's is going to play a big part in that, because I'll tell you, I got a lot of mileage out of Joe's Donuts.
I've only lived here for 10 years, and when I first moved here, I knew how to go to work, and I knew how to go to Joe's Bakery, and that was it. If I got off any of these streets, I was lost.
All right.
I remember coming here when I was a little child, and now I'm 24 years old, and I won't ever come here again, and it's real sad, but no. I'll survive. I go down the street to Abdul Gasser Fasser and get Twinkies instead of cream puffs. And nope, not nearly as good, but it's fast.
I have friends that come great distances to go to this place.
I bet you're one of them.
Yeah.
It's even great that the officers patronize this place.
Hey, I'm a KU grad.
That's right.
He's got one up on me.
Vince O'Neill played football.
Well, that's when I found out Joe was closing, why it kind of hit a deep spot with me, because being the milkman, why this is always my first stop, and Joe was always happy to greet me, and it's always been very, very nice to be able to deal with Joe throughout the years. It seemed like he always had a smile for me whenever I got here in the morning, and I don't know what I'll do now next year. It's milk truck will automatically drop by here, and anyhow, probably, because it's been doing this now for 15 years, stopping here the first thing in the morning.
I have standing beside me Ralph Smith, Joe's son, and how does it feel to be going out of business?
Oh, it's kind of sad right now, but I'm glad to see my father getting out of it, because he's worked long, he's worked hard hours, but he deserves a good retirement.
What do you do now that Joe's is closed?
Well, right now, I really don't know. kind of up in the air. Who knows? Maybe I'll be down here next year. I don't know. I wouldn't say that for sure, though.
How was last night as a farewell night?
I was busy. Busy, another crazy night at Joe's.
We got summer vacation.
Thank you.
See you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Have a nice summer.
You too. That's nice.
Yes, the bakery did close for the summer as usual, but this time Joe was retiring to his home in the country for good. He would not be the one to reopen the bakery in the fall. Joe first became interested in baking at the end of World War II when he served as a cook in the Navy.
The war got over and they had a lot more sailors than they needed and they started giving us our discharges. And of course I was glad to get mine. Come back to my hometown of Tonganoxie and went back and finished my senior year in high school, and I had that one semester to go.
Upon completing his senior year of high school, Joe worked at various bakeries in the area, including the Sunbeam Bakeries in Kansas City and Topeka, Ford's Bakery in Lawrence, and Kay's Bakery, which would later become Joe's Bakery. In addition to his working experience, Joe graduated from Chicago's American Institute of Baking.
I had made applications to go to this American Institute of Baking, which was in Chicago at the time, and there's where I got approved, and I went to that school. I went through it, which lasted like 20 weeks, I think it was.
After graduation, Joe returned to Kansas and again worked in area bakeries. While working at Kay's Bakery, the owner, Bosco Faring, offered the ownership of the bakery to Joe. He accepted.
In 52, he decided that he'd like to sell it, and he sold it to me then in 52. And then I've been there just about ever since, which is about accumulation of about 28 years.
Having hung up his baking apron for good, Joe now keeps busy tending to the daily chores of the farm.
Pretty warm right here in this barn right now, but I don't believe it's still quite as hot as it was that last night in the bakery down there when it seemed like everybody in town paid us a visit and stopped in and seen us that night. But it got pretty warm there in the back room trying to keep up with them. But I've got a few feed my cows a little bit here. Now it's a little bit early. I don't generally have to start feeding them this early, but being that drought had kind of dried our grass up and so on like that, I have to feed the cows a few bales of hay every day now to keep them alive, I guess, because they're just a little short on grass right now. And then towards the back side of the place here, why I have quite a bit of timber on the place, and it's out in the middle of it, I have what I call the Treasure Island. I have this place where I put anything that gets too old to work or worn out or just a piece of implement that's just been hanging around. I've got it place cleared off back in the timber there, and I call that my Treasure Island. In fact, everything that I don't have use for, I stick it back in there, and that's where I keep most of my unused things back there.
Thank you.
this is the back side of the farm here now, and it's on a big hill that faces off towards the north, looks out towards Lake Perry. You can see Ham's Quarry up there, Highway 24, and a few farms that lay between in the Call Bottom down there. And I really enjoy getting back here, because most of the time you're just back here by yourself. You can't see any other life other than maybe your animals just run around here. But this is just kind of a good place on the place to come and be by yourself, do a little thinking, and spend a little time. And I've enjoyed this hill quite a bit since I've had it, and just for that simple reason. It's gets cold back here in the wintertime because of it's open to the north wind that blows down through the valley there. And this has been sort of my favorite spot, just to go and be by myself.
Smith retired and the bakery was closed. But by the end of the summer, Joe's bakery was reopened and back in business, this time with a new owner, Ralph Smith, Joe's son.